God sent the prophet Isaiah to comfort people, tell them that a Messiah was coming who would bring the kingdom of heaven down to earth with him. And then the wolf would live with the lamb. And then the leopard would nap with the goat. And there the calf, the lion, and the yearling play together. And here a little child will lead us. In the fullness of time, Christ came, full of power and wonder. And people left their lives to follow him. And these disciples asked Jesus, "Where is the kingdom of heaven? When is it coming?" He called a little child to him and placed the child among them. And he said, "Truly I tell you, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of God." Here to pretend we don't know the story. We are here because we know the one born in the manger. We know what is coming. We know what we are waiting for. Shepherds and angels, wise men and thwarted kings. We open our mouths to sing Gloria in Excelsis. We open our hands to lift a candle high in the sacred dark. We are ready to love the child and be loved by him. Love is here. Love is waiting. And we are here, waiting for love.
We're all hoping, we're all hopeless. We're all thorns and we're all roses. We're all looking down our noses at ourselves. We're all searching for somebody to love.
There comes a day when what satisfies doesn't. When we can no longer ignore the disquiet in our hearts. The ache in our souls is too much to bear. When we see, in spite of ourselves, that what we have is not enough. The great African theologian Augustine told us, "Our hearts are restless until they find their rest in you, O Lord." Sometimes the ache grows slowly until all of a sudden we can no longer deny it. And we have to cast our lot with God. In fear and trembling, we turn to God. Sovereign, holy, almighty, redeemer, maker, lion. But the power of God, the presence of God, is not what we expected or feared. Like the soul-sick prophet Elijah, we did not find God's power in the winds of the hurricane, or the destruction of the earthquake, or the flames of fire. But after all these came a still, small voice, gentleness, tenderness, a revelation more beautiful than our fearful hearts can bear.
Yeah.
Once we see the beauty of God, all our religion falls away. And we cry out with the voice of the ancients, "Who can ascend to your holy hill, God? Who can stand before you? The one with clean hands and a pure heart. We are not that one." Beloved ones, hear the good news of the gospel. This beauty is for us, not against us. The goodness of God is medicine for the sick. It is strength for the weak. It is rescue for the lost. The goodness of God is not saved for the pure, the strong, or the perfect. It is not for those with perfect faith. It is for us. We look at this sun and see the God who cannot be seen. We look at this sun and see God's original purpose in everything created. For everything, absolutely everything, above and below, visible and invisible, rank after rank of angels, everything got started in him and finds its purpose in him. He was there before any of it came into existence and holds it all together even in this moment. Everything of God finds its proper place in him without crowding. Not only that, but all the broken and dislocated pieces of the universe, people and things, animals and atoms, get properly fixed and fit together in vibrant harmonies. God, who is the source of all things, is worthy and able to receive all things and restore all things. Christ is worthy of it all.
Right.
Jesus came to gather all the lost and little and broken and blind ones, all of us, to himself. He accepts us as we are, with all our pain and all our problems. He comes in love to gather us into his goodness. Jesus comes to the world as it is, not as it should be. Jesus comes to the world as it is, and in him it becomes as it should be. So he calls us to the most astonishing work of all, rest. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Will you pray with me, please? God, in freedom and faith, we offer you all we have to give, our burdens, our love. Hear us as we name what crushes us. Hear us as we give to you the burdens we can no longer bear. God, give us the grace to hear you reply. You are Emmanuel, God with us. We can come to you weary and burdened as we are, and you will give us rest and a yoke of joy.
Go tell it on the mountain.
Savior of the world is born.
to him who is able, to him who is able to keep you from stumbling, to him who is able to present you before his glorious presence, to him who is able to present you without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, to our God who is able, be glory, majesty, power, authority, through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, now and forevermore, forever and ever. Amen.
All of creation is singing the song of oldest age, echoing heaven. We join the angels as they sing.